Here's an example of the BatchView client. This BatchView client is designed to allow you to compare repeated events. In this case, we're using, I guess, a very traditional repeated event. That would be a batch of pharmaceuticals, for example. In the pharmaceutical industry, they're making the same product over and over again in some predefined recipes that are fairly similar to each other. So imagine that you've got, as we see in gold here, a perfect instance of that batch. You made it the best you ever have made that product before, and you'd like to be able to compare your current batches and other batches to that best batch you ever made. Well, this would be a great tool to do that, because what we're looking at here is we're looking at search results that are looking for a specific product given a certain time span, and then comparing, for example, the flow, or we could look at the temperature, comparing different things that have happened during that particular batch. So if we look, this is what the temperature profile of that particular batch look, those particular sets of batches look like. So we're comparing events to each other. If you look at the absolute time, these are all occurring at different times, but we superimpose them on top of each other because it's just easier to make comparisons. So by making comparison, we can learn from that best batch, or from the aggregate of batches that we look at, the averages, you know, what works best for a particular product or particular procedure, recipe. There's all kinds of nice features we've built into this. For example, I can dig down through this, drill down through this, and zoom in on particular steps. We'll go ahead and look at just the drop step there. This is comparing the drop phases. Now, they're all currently all aligned within the start of the batch, but I could actually align this to the start of that particular phase or that particular subunit. Let me go ahead and restore this back. And I can do that for any of these, the mix phase, the drop phase. I can align to that so that we're looking at just, we're comparing like batches that we're comparing them all at the same time. If you look at these, they're all aligned now at their drop phase here. Now, so far I've discussed comparing one batch to the other, comparing these repeated events one to another, but you can also compare the different units that are involved. For example, if we take a look at this in time, I'll go into the configuration. I'm going to switch this over to absolute instead of relative time, instead of relative to the start of the batch. You can see that some of these actually overlap, and they overlap because they're being done in different mixers. There's different pieces of equipment involved here. You see, this is the most recent one. It's in one mixer. These are in different mixers here. I further point this out, I suppose, by going into my layout. Let me configure this Gantt chart so that on the unit batch we're actually looking at the unit name. As you can see, these are this is giving you a good idea of which is mixer 1 and which is mixer 2. And one of the interesting things you can do, if you go back far enough, let's go back and see if we find some more batches. Let's go back and get it. Let's look at all of these batches within that start to end period. Yeah, there's an awful lot of batches here. But what we can do, I've probably gotten too many now, but we can compare mixer 1 and 2 and see if we're running this comparably. Is there the same amount of turnaround time between each? So let me go in and change this. Let's just go with the last 20 of these batches. Now, so let me zoom in here, and what I'm looking for is any, you know, this is mixer 2, this is mixer 1. I'm looking for any, this is interesting here, it looks like between mixer 1, yeah, there seems to be a gap here between the turnaround between these two events. So you're looking for things like that. You're looking for anything that indicates that maybe people are running it differently. There's a longer turnaround time between different pieces of equipment. And so for doing those types of comparisons, we offer the BatchView tools.